Hello everyone, you on Serious Destination, SD for short, your authentic herbal remedy and health solution. Before you watch this video, subscribe to the channel so you will not miss any health tip and solution. Today we are going to talk about the ulcer, how you end your ulcer without a doctor. Before we begin, what are ulcers? One dangerous and tormenting ailment is the peptic ulcer. Gastric and duodenal ulcers are peptic ulcers. Both of them are known as peptic ulcers, which are open sores in the lining of the digestive tract. Gastric ulcers form in the lining of the stomach, while duodenal ulcers develop in the lining of the duodenum, which is the upper part of the small intestine. The picture illustrates how the duodenal and the gastric ulcers are formed. Now let's talk about some common causes of ulcers. One common factor of causing ulcer is an infection caused by Helicobacter pylori. This is a bacteria found in food that affects the stomach. Another factor is excessive use of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs or pain relievers, that is aspirin. Another cause is a diet too rich in fat. Yet another cause is caffeine, then excessive consumption of alcohol and smoking tobacco. Another cause of ulcer is radiotherapy. Yet another cause is strong gastric acidity. One thing you should note is stress and spicy foods do not cause peptic ulcer. However, they can make your symptoms worse. Now let's talk about the symptoms of ulcers. Burning sensation or pain in the stomach. 2. Poor digestion. Then 3. Bloating. 4. Is lack of appetite for food. 5. Is nausea followed by vomiting. The 6th is belching and weight loss. Now, to relieve ulcers, there are so many herbs and natural and home remedies recommended by therapists. But today, we are just going to look at one common fruit we all know and we are familiar with to cure and take care of that stubborn ulcer. And this is the pawpaw or the papaya. Its scientific name is Carica papaya, and the tree call it Brofre. The Evers call it Adiba. The Ghana people call it Akpakpa. The kingdom it's from is the Plantae kingdom, and the family is Caricaceae. Genus is Carica. Now this is an example of unripe papaya, which we are going to use for this remedy. Then we have the ripe papaya, as you see here. You see the seeds become black and the peel become yellowish. That is typical example of ripe papaya. Now before we dive into everything or how to use this papaya, let's talk about its nutritional values. Now, fresh nutritive papaya per 100 gram will give you this nutritional values or nutritions. Now, this data is from USDA National Nutrient and Database. Now, the principal nutrient in the papaya is energy. The nutrient value is 43 kilocalories. Then the percentage of RDA is 2%. RDA simply means recommended dietary allowance. Now, carbohydrate is 10.82 grams. which is 8% of RDA. Protein is 0.47 gram, which is 1% of RDA. Total fat is 0.26 grams, which is 1% of RDA. Dietary fiber being 1.70 grams, which is 4% of RDA. Now let's talk about the vitamins contained in the papaya. We have the niacin, that is the vitamin B3, being 0.338 milligrams, 2% of RDA. We have the folate being 37 micrograms, 9% of the RDA. We have the pantothenic acid, that is vitamin B5, being 0.218 milligrams of 4% of RDA. We have the pyridoxine, that is vitamin B6, which is 0.038 milligrams, 3% of RDA. Then we have the riboflavin, that is what we know as vitamin B2, which contains 0.027 milligrams as the value in the papaya, then 2% of RDA. Then we have the thiamine, which is the vitamin B1, 0.023 milligrams, 2% RDA. We have the vitamin A, which is 950 international units, that is the 32% of RDA per 100 grams of papaya. Then we have the vitamin C, which is 60.9 milligrams, and it's made up of 102% RDA. We have the vitamin E, which is 0.30 milligrams, 2% of RDA. We have the vitamin K, 2.6 microgram, 2% of RDA. Now let's talk about some electrolytes in the papaya. Electrolytes. We have the sodium, which is 8 milligrams, 0.5% of RDA. Potassium, 182 milligrams, 4% of RDA. Now the minerals in papaya, we have the calcium, 20 milligrams, 2% of RDA. Iron is 0.25 milligrams, 3% of RDA. We have the magnesium being 21 milligrams, 5% of RDA. We have the phosphorus, 10 milligrams, 1% of RDA. We have the zinc, which is 0.08 milligrams, 0.5% of RDA. Now, phytonutrients in papaya. We have the carotene beta, which is 276 micrograms. We have the cryptoxanthin beta, which is 761 micrograms. Then we have the lutein zeaxanthin, which is 75 micrograms in the papaya. After dealing with this table and knowing the nutritional value of papaya, now let's dive into what we are to do with the papaya to cure our ulcer. There are so many ways to use the papaya, but we are going to just look at one ailment and one aspect of using the papaya. Ingredients needed for this activity or this remedy is unripe papaya or the unripe pawpaw, not the ripe, the unripe, just as is shown on the screen. Then the water, filtered clean water. Now you get the unripe papaya and you wash it very, very well. Make sure you wash it very well and do not peel or remove any seed from it. Then after carefully cleaning the outside, just cut it into slices without peeling it. Just don't peel it. Cut everything, both the seed and the peels. Cut everything into slices. Now put all the small pieces of papaya you have cut in a clean container. After putting them in a very clean container, fill the container with water to stop at the same point that the sliced papaya has stopped. You have to fill the container with water to stop at the same point that the sliced papaya has stopped. Do not exceed that level or below that level. Let it stop at where the papaya has stopped, because of the nutrient and the energy in the papaya is enough with the same level of water. Now, you leave this papaya in the water for 4 days. For example, if you soak it on Monday, Friday will be the fourth day. You just count Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday is the fourth day. Now, on the fourth day, the water in the papaya will be white. You can observe the water being whitish. Then you filter the water and discard the papaya. You just filter the water, pour the water, then you throw the papaya away. But one thing you should notice, you can also use it with the papaya or the sliced papaya inside for at least a week before discarding the papaya. Now, the dosage you have to take after you have completed everything is half a glass of this water every morning, afternoon, and evening. You have to take this remedy thrice a day. It should be thrice a day. Do not exceed it and do not take it below it if you really want to be cured, and very fast too. After taking this, you no longer feel the obstructive pains, as they will be healed by the papaya water or the pawpaw water that you have mixed. They will be healed by them. So the internal pain or the internal sores or wounds causing the pain will all be healed. You can continue this remedy for weeks and months depending on the severity of the ulcer. You know how long that ulcer had been with you. So if you have gotten the remedy, if the pain stops, continue administering the remedy and you will get rid of it totally. Don't stop immediately the pain stops. Administer it, continue using it, and you will totally cure everything without it returning back. Now, one thing you should note is the above remedy or the above treatment doesn't prevent you from seeing the doctor or going to the hospital, because not all stomach pains or not all stomach burns are ulcers. What you have to know is that be sure you have been diagnosed and you know that you are dealing with an ulcer before you apply the methods above. And always remember, prevent it before it gets to the cure. Maybe you won't be fortunate enough to get the cure as early as it can be cured. Always remember, health takes nothing from you, but gives you all you require to live a healthy and successful life. And with Serious Destination, you just name the disease and you are cured indeed. Share to save a life of another. That someone, that special someone out there needs your help to be cured. You share this, that person will be cured. And thank you to all your comments and contributions are welcome. Remember, Serious Destination is equal to Light of Health. Stay tuned and watch out for the next video. Thank you.